In this video, we are going to discuss about dynamic method dispatch in Java. First, let's see when dynamic method dispatch is possible, and then we will discuss what is dynamic method dispatch with the help of a program. Dynamic method dispatch is possible only while implementing inheritance. We know what is inheritance. The process of creating a new class from old class is known as inheritance. Here the base class contains only its members, whereas derived class contains its members as well as its base class members. Let us assume that derived class is not satisfied with the base class method definition. Then derived class can provide its own implementation for the corresponding method. Let's see this example. Here we have a class called A, so this is the base class, and this base class contains a method called show. The body of the show method is system.out.println class A show method. And we have created two classes, class B and class C, by inheriting from A. So A is the base class from which we have created two classes, B and C. Let us assume that class B is not satisfied with class A show method definition. So that's why class B want to provide its own definition for the show method. So that is the definition. So class B is providing its own implementation for the show method. So what is that body? System.out.println class B show method. So likewise, we have created class C by inheriting from the base class class A. Here also class C is not satisfied with its base class, that is class A show method definition. So that's why it is providing its own definition for the show method. So the body of the show method is system.out.println class C. So next we have to define the main method. For that we have to declare a class. Let name of the class is test. So inside the test class, let us define main method. So public static void main string args. Now let's see what is dynamic method dispatch. Dynamic means a runtime. Dynamic method dispatch is also called as runtime polymorphism. So the decision about which method will be called is decided during runtime or execution time. So that's why this mechanism is known as dynamic method dispatch. Here, while implementing dynamic method dispatch, we always create a reference for the parent class. So here, what is the parent class? A is the parent class. So for the parent class, we have to create the reference. We should not create object for the parent class. So create a reference for the parent class. Next we have to store child class object in parent class reference. So what is the parent class reference? REF. So REF is equal to R. Let us create an object for its child class. So here B is the child class. So for B, let us create an object. So B obj1 is equal to new B. So here an object is created for the class B. So what is the name of the object? Obj1 is the name of the object. So next we have to store that child class object in parent class reference. So we can write as REF is equal to obj1. So what we are doing? We are storing child class object in parent class reference. So this is nothing but a reference, whereas with the help of new operator we are creating an object. So this concept is known as upcasting. So upcasting means if a parent class reference contains child class object, then it is known as upcasting. And now if we access the show method with the help of the reference, then which show method will be called? So let us write a statement, ref.show. So here what is the problem? REF is a reference which belongs to class A. Okay. So now we have show method in both class A as well as class B. OBJ1 is an object for class B. So which show method will be called? Whether class A show method or class B show method. So that will be decided based upon the right hand side object that we assigned. So here, what is the right hand side object that we assigned? OBJ1. So OBJ1 is nothing but class B object. So now class B show method will be called. So this is the point here. The decision about which show method will be called, that will be resolved during runtime or execution time. So which show method will be called now? Here our reference contains OBJ1. OBJ1 is class B object. So the class B show method will be called. So what is the body of class B show method? Class B show. So this message will be printed on the monitor. So this decision, which show method will be called? It will be decided during execution time. If we want, we can combine these three statements into a single statement like, so what is the reference? A, REF is equal to new B. We can combine these three statements into a single statement like this. So REF is the reference which belongs to parent class, whereas B is the object. Okay. Next, let us call the show method which is present in class C. So with the help of a single statement, we can write, already a reference is created for class A. So what is that name? REF. REF is equal to, so create an object for the C class. So REF is equal to new C. Now call the show method. So REF dot show. So now which show method will be called? Here our REF contains this class C object. So the class C show method will be called. So what is class C show method? Class C show will be called. So class C show method will be called. So this decision, which show method will be called? This decision will be taken during runtime or execution time. So that's why it is known as dynamic method dispatching. Here always upcasting is possible, but downcasting is not possible. Downcasting means if your child class reference contains parent class object, then it is known as downcasting. But here Java doesn't support downcasting. Let us assume that we have written a statement like this. So B, REF is equal to new A. So is it a valid statement? No, it is not a valid statement. Why? Because here B is the child class. So in child class reference, what we are doing? We are storing parent class object. So this is not possible here. And this is known as downcasting. Okay, this is not possible. Next to close the main method, next to close the corresponding class. So this is about dynamic method dispatch in Java programming.